Hello everyone, I'm going to explain you how to set up BuddyX theme with BuddyPress with this default data and which can be erased easily after your testing. First of all, I am going to install the BuddyX theme which I have already uploaded from search and installed from the WordPress repo. You can search BuddyX on the WordPress search and then install it and activate it. After the theme installation, we have simplified the steps. Now it only recommends two plugins. The Elementor page builder, that is an optional one, Kirkip toolkit, that is mandatory, and the classic wizard, I have included one because right now all the plugins what we are using, they are not compatible with the wizard logic of the WordPress 5.8. I'm going to install all of them. Okay, after installing and activating these plugins, I'm going to install the BuddyPress. Along with the BuddyPress, I'm going to activate one more plugin, BuddyPress default data, which is also provided by the one of the core contributor of the BuddyPress. This will create all the dummy content for the BuddyPress member, messages, activities, and the best part is these details can be deleted in one click. I'm also looking for one more plugin, BuddyPress. It will help you to create any custom post type data like a blog or pages like that one, so I can demonstrate you how your post and the blog look like. And the same benefit with the BuddyPress, you can also delete those dummy posts in one click. Okay, first of all, I'm going to set up with the BuddyPress theme. After activating the BuddyPress, it automatically creates a couple of pages. Navigate to the setting BuddyPress and activate all the components what it have. Inside the setting options, you can also enable the post comment, and BuddyPress Novo will be the default selection option. By default, it will create three map pages: member, activity, stream, user groups. And if you have the registration enabled, it will also activate two more pages, activate and register page. Okay, the first setting is going to create the demo data for the BuddyPress. Go to the tools and bb default data. When you are going to create the dummy profile, you have to create them step by step. Like just most of the people can try on the shared hosting on the local host to avoid any timeout or anything. I will suggest to create the user first and then create groups. So I'm creating user first. After that one, I'm going to create groups. So right now you can view that the groups and friend connection, activity post, private messages group, and it also included the members inside those groups, and it also created some activities inside the groups. And you can view that there is a button clear BuddyPress data. So with the help of this button, you can also delete all these created activities in one click. Okay, next I'm going to create some blog post. So I'm going to create suppose that 15 blog posts which can be deleted in one click. Okay, and when you are going to create blog post, you can also cut down some attributes from here. So just to make sure it look like a little bit clean. I'm not going to use all those h tag like this one. And for the image one, place instead of the placeholder, much better to use random images there. And that's all, random images there. And for the thumbnail, we are also going to use the random images. Next, hit on the generate. It will create a couple of blog posts inside your site, and from the setting option you can also delete them in one click. Okay, next I'm going to create the menus. First I'm going to create a primary menu option and including all the pages what we have here. Add to the menu, save menu. Okay, I'm also going to create one more page for the blog one, so I can use it for the mapping of the blog page. We can also use home page as a blog page using index page. Publish. Next. The next is the user menu. For the user menu, there is inside the screen option, you have the BuddyPress members, enable it. Then you can include all the menu for that one. So it will give the menus for the logged in user. Add your menu. And you can map it to the user menu location. The first menu what we have created earlier, that need to be mapped for the primary menu. So you can also do that from here, quickly map them. Okay, now the front look of the website, how it look like with the default data, what we have. The home page, it have some dummy post. It have some activities like this one. Now we have to set up the sidebar and all those things. It have the groups and member. Okay, next thing what we have to do here, I'm going to set up the logo and the options what we have. So I can demonstrate it more properly. You can change the color scheme from here. From the site identity setting, I'm just going to set up a logo there. Okay, you have logo set. Next thing, I'm going to set up the sidebar options. So by default, I'm going to use the both sidebar options. And for the blog page, I'm going to use the full width. Okay. After adding the sidebar, we can include the widgets from the here. Right now, inside the theme, we have a community left sidebar, activity directory right sidebar. So these are the BuddyPress specific sidebar. And for that, on the left sidebar, I'm going to include visit here, like suppose that the first one is a group. You're free to use any wizard there, that's completely your call. I'm just populating something so we have a clear navigation how it look like. Okay, in the right side, this is the member directory right side, so include the login. File completion. From the general setting, you can also increase the container width, which is by default set as 1170. You can go with the 1270 or the 1370, like this one, so it will give you more space for the placement. For the site loader, you can enable it or disable it, it's completely option. For the page mapping, you can also create a custom landing page for the login page, and you can also map the register page when you have register open. And you can also set a 404 page where any error page could lead for the default error message. Okay, the next is the typography. By default, we have all the typography options here. And you can easily set for the heading typography, menu typography. And same goes for the body. Okay, now you can do that. We have a basic skeleton ready with activity sidebar. Let me include some wizards here also. Activity directory sidebar, profile completion, same for the group sidebar. Okay, we also have dedicated sidebar location for the member single profile and the group profile. Okay, now the activity page look like this one. Okay, and next is the home page, which is driven by the blog element. So go to and customize section again. For the blog section, we have given in the recent update, we have included a couple of new options. Click on the blog, so you can also have a list view like this one. A thumbnail view where you can display the content and display in the multiple grid column like this. You can also have this grid layout, which is can be used as a default view also. And you can also display it in a 2 or 3 column with the Pinterest like layout or default regular layout. Okay, publish it. And you can also display sidebar from the sidebar setting. For the single blog post, suppose that I'm opening a single blog post, we have also included a couple of new options here. Like you can, I have set a container width here, so the content looked self-adjusted here. And you can also display this featured image top of the meta element like this one. We have one more option here like this, and the next one is where you can display the featured image on the top and then the author meta will be displayed. It's now your call, which layout looks much better to you, and you can use the same layout for your website default blog options. Publish. That's all. So you have a full-fledged working model of the BuddyX theme, how it can be used. This is the blog page. You have multiple options how you are going to demonstrate it. Activity page with all the activity functionalities, and we also are providing a couple of functionality for the community to enrich it using hashtag, poll, status, code, profanity, moderation. So you can also take a look of those plugins at our website, and which can help you to make your community more engaging. And for the group functionality, you can see that everything is here. On the group page, in the new update, what we have included here, on the edit group, we have a quick link here, the change group photos and the change cover image photo for the group, and same goes to the member profile also. And next thing is the mobile view. So in the mobile view, we have also improved couple of things, like this one. You have message and the notification icon on the top. When you have WooCommerce enabled, it will also display the WooCommerce element there. Cart icon, and the primary menu will goes like this one, and the user menu will display below that one. So in that way, your members which are using BuddyPress, they can easily navigate to corresponding profile element as well. Hopefully it will explain you how to set up the dummy data. Now I'm going to reset it quickly. So for the BuddyPress, what you have to do, let it go. Just you have to type it, and then it will delete all the blog element which are created by the BuddyPress. Done. All data gone. Now same for the tools, BP default data. I'm going to clear all the BuddyPress data. So any details what you have created, dummy details what you have created, is now lost. So it will be much better to get an exact idea how the BuddyPress is working and how the theme is working, and then you can start populating the real content from your community with the help of your community members. Hopefully BuddyX will help you to create your engaging community. And if you have any questions, for any you're looking for any suggestions to enhance your community, contact us. We will help you. Thank you.